painting, sculptures, and photographs of an art show get much of the attention. But what about the space where the artworks are displayed? For this week's In Focus, Sarah Madison tours an old attic of a schoolhouse in Grand Rapids that's been transformed into an inspirational art gallery for the community.
What used to be an empty attic has become a lively dwelling for local artists.
One of the things that I suggested was, wouldn't it be great if we could have an artist in residence in Central School, because there were spaces available.
The program is called Artists in Residence, and every 3 months, 2 to 3 new artists share this space to display, create, and educate.
You know, the ceilings in here are about 25 feet to the peak, and that allows me to really play with some ideas that I normally wouldn't be able to.
This is a really great growth space, and it's the fact that it reinforces what I'm doing is really important to me.
Artists say this space is inspirational. With great lighting, a high ceiling, and historic architecture, their imaginations can run wild.
It just hasn't been a space that people who are interested in buying something or shopping want to make it all the way up here, but it's perfect for working artists and people who want to learn from the artists.
The mission of this space is to bring artists and arts to the community. Both of the occupants have been enjoying the third level and each other's company for more than a month.
You know, we try to get as many people up here as possible to see the work, and it's obviously having two artists helps that. But then in the same sense, we bounce ideas off of each other and help each other out with critiquing and thinking about the work.
Every day we're learning, we're trying something new, so we're sort of continuing the function of the school. It's perfect.
The Artist in Residence program not only gives these artists public exposure, but also brings people to this landmark building that is also on the National Register of Historic Places.
People are curious to come up here. So we get lots of visitors. We get people who went to school here.
Just to think about that there used to be a bell tower up here, that there was a skylight that's now been roofed over. But there's all these sort of things that have changed, and it's sort of interesting to think about just the history of the building itself and how you can be part of the evolution of that.
The space will remain the same for another month until a new rotation of artists comes in. For this week's In Focus, Sarah Madison, Lakeland News.
Rent is free of charge and all art forms are accepted in this space. Interested artists are encouraged to apply at grandrapidsarts.org.
If you've enjoyed this segment of Lakeland News, please consider making a tax-deductible contribution to Lakeland Public Television.